Okay, there's a side view of my knife making machine, 2x72 belt grinder. I'll kind of give you some shots of what makes this thing tick here. I've got a 2x10 inch contact wheel mounted on a 1 inch shaft that's turned down to 7/8. The hole in that contact wheel is 7/8, and that's threaded, and that butt nut keeps the wheel tight on there. Got 2 1-inch McGill C-05 pillar blocks on that shaft, and that's a 4 1/4 inch drive pulley there. It goes back to a Dayton motor. It's a 1.5 horse 3450, and the pulley on it's about 2 inches. The tension that is provided for this machine comes off of this back arm here that's mounted on the half-inch plate. That's what the whole grinder is mounted on. It comes up that arm right there, and this device here is two pieces of tubing with a spring that provides the pressure to that back arm. I've got my rest, it's bolted in there. That's all hand fabricated material. It's 1/4 inch thick and 4 inches wide. And I just heated that and bent it till I got it right. And then I made this pedestal here and slotted it so it can be adjusted. That's actually a piece of 3/16 by, 2 inch angle iron that I notched out and made my rest out of. So this is very doable. You can actually make your own machine and make a multi-purpose machine like mine. I use this for many different things. And a machine like this will last for many, many years. Don't look like much. The paint is worn off of it. When it was new, it was like some kind of Chrysler blue engine paint. It looked pretty to begin with. I thought about taking it all down and have it powder coated, but I'm not sure about that. That would be pretty neat. Seems like I'm always using it, and I wouldn't want anything to get lost off of it. There's your knife making machine right there.